On the 25th of December 2021, NASA gave us all an unprecedented Christmas gift, the James Webb, a $10 billion space telescope that's expected to tell us more about the universe than any other telescope before it. Since its launch, scientists have been working effortlessly to prepare it for the first big reveal. And after months of waiting, it's finally here. Ever since its conception, the Webb has garnered a sizable amount of buzz. But not too many would have thought it would be big enough to grab the attention of the President of the United States. However, just recently, President Joe Biden suspended his hectic schedule to share the first images shot by the gold-plated James Webb telescope. This iconic event would go down in history as a once-in-a-lifetime event. But like most revolutionary projects, the journey from development to completion wasn't an easy one. Developed for more than three decades, Webb is the most advanced space observatory equipment ever built. After a few months of testing, NASA engineers were able to configure the 18 individual hexagonal mirrors aboard the James Webb telescope, making the giant 21-foot gold-plated mirror come alive. As per the calibration process, NASA positioned Webb to capture the image of a generic star that is about 100 times dimmer than what the normal human eye can see. Identified as 2-mass J17, it was chosen because it had the right brightness level, which turned out to be the best precision test for the mirror alignment. Staring in closely on the image, you find an array of tiny dots sprinkled around the star, which is, without a doubt, the center of attraction. Scientists say these tiny dots are galaxies that are billions of light years away and had never been explored prior to the introduction of the James Webb telescope. Also, the epic tire was regarded as a deep field image, meaning it captured some of the farthest objects in the universe. With the complex procedures of calibrating the segmented mirrors and the T's image release, expectations hit the roof in anticipation of the official reveal of Webb's first images. Fast forward to July 11, 2022. James Webb's first real shot have been revealed by President Joe Biden, unveiling the SMAX-0723 galaxy. What you can see here is a deep field view of a section of the night sky 4.6 billion years ago. Universe scale-wise, the monitored area was as big as a grain of sand on the tip of your hands. The picture was taken with Webb's NERC cam and took about 12 and a half hours to make, proving how amazing the telescope operates. To put that into context, the Hubble Space Telescope did a 100-hour shot just about in this section in 1995, known as Hubble Deep Field, and its amazing results are far behind what James Webb has to offer. Speaking about the reveal, Biden described the feat as a new window into the history of our universe, and he was absolutely right. What you can see here is a teaser of the capabilities of the telescope, which we will cover. But the data on this one is absolutely out of this world. Wasp 96b is a gigantic and extremely hot exoplanet, mainly composed of gases as seen by Webb from 1150 light years. The instrument was able to analyze the atmosphere of the exoplanet and became the very first one in human history to catch all the color spectrum of it. As WASP 96b completes a full orbit around its star every 3.4 days, it could be observed 7 times in a week. According to the data gathered by the instruments, the exoplanet's atmosphere contains water vapor, meaning that we could observe clouds on it despite the fact that it is more hotter than any other known planet in the solar system. The procedure requires extremely precise calibration and measurements, as the phenomenon could only be observed when the planet passes in front of the star, and the telescope can only then collect data about the atoms that make up the atmosphere, as well as the temperature of it. The next image of the instrument absolutely shocked the scientific community, and it offered findings we didn't even dare to collect. Take a look at the NGC 3132 planetary nebula in the constellation Vela, some 2,000 light years away as seen by Webb. On the left side, you can see how the telescope's NERC cam caught the nebula. On the right side, it's all the same. However, this shot was taken with instrument MIRI, aka mid-infrared instrument. This picture is more than important for humanity, and it could tell us about how stars are formed and how they affect their environment. Webb already discovered that the star in the center of the nebula that is responsible for gas emission for thousands of years are covered in cosmic dust. Just for the sake of comparison, take a look at NGC 2131, as seen by Hubble, and see the difference. It is clear that the James Webb Space Telescope is by far our best equipment yet, and well worth every penny. Moving on for the Stevens Quintet picture, the galaxy group that resides 290 million light years from us has been discovered in 1877 and is frequently observed, making it the perfect target to aim James Webb to. What we can see here is a galaxy group of five, and the very first one to be known as being interacting with each other. In time, four of the galaxies will collide, and most likely they will become one. And that's exactly why the telescope is observing the area, as this unique phenomenon can reveal a lot about the evolution of galaxies and interaction forces. This picture features the biggest spectrum of the night sky so far by Webb, and it is as big as 20% of the Moon as seen from Earth. Of course, the telescope took the shot by pieces, and it's been put all together later to form this outstanding view. But there is a more shocking photo that the James Webb showed to us, and it is none other than the Eta Carinia Cloud, as seen by NERCam and MIRI from 7,600 light years. The photo has been put together to simultaneously show the clouds and the hundreds of galaxies in the background across the universe. At the center of this photo, you can see one of the brightest and most massive stars in the Milky Way. This shot is more than important for Webb and all of the scientific community, as it gives us a unique opportunity to witness something very rare. The star got very close to killing itself 175 years ago. But in the end, something different took place. Hence, a cloud-forming region can be seen within the cloud. It is a highly important region for the mission, as hundreds of the stars are born in this section, making it the perfect place for Webb to observe. The telescope can be capable of detecting gas flow in the cloud, as well as observing very small regions. But there is more to that picture, as it is the very first one to feature the birth of a star. This period only lasts from 50 to 100,000 years, so it is more than difficult to witness. But with the James Webb telescope, that's no longer the case. Besides being invaluable, all the pictures are astonishing to watch and made it 100% clear that the James Webb mission is already a success story.